There are many ways deer get exposed to CWD-causing prions, but generally they fall under two categories, direct and indirect contact. Direct contact is when prions are passed from deer to deer. Indirect contact is when deer are exposed to prions through contaminated objects or in the environment. In a natural system, infected deer may spread disease as they interact with other deer, like within family or social groups, or with the environment. Management decisions can affect how deer interact with each other and the landscape. For example, adding attractants like mineral blocks, bait, or feeders can increase deer interactions. An attractant causes deer to cluster around it, leading to more direct contact than in a natural habitat. So, when the disease enters the environment, it may spread faster because of the increased contact rate around the attractant. Deer management can also alter the density of deer on the landscape. The number of direct contacts may decrease when deer density is reduced as social groups are disrupted, causing individuals to spread out. Alternatively, indirect contact at feeding areas can expose deer to prions shed by infected deer in their saliva, urine, and feces. Areas with many deer or few foraging areas may increase indirect contact rates. Habitat management, like timber harvest and prescribed burns, can increase preferred foraging areas and reduce indirect contact. Many factors may influence contact rate between deer and prions, including attractants, deer density, and relative food availability. These considerations make CWD spread complex and unique to each area. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe for more videos on CWD and deer.